What's happening, everybody? Jeff Lightsy Jr. here with the Ball Sports Network. Thank you guys for the continued support. Continue to hit the like, share, subscribe, and the notification bell to upload videos every single day. Now, it's a new year with a new coach, but it's the same old Dallas Cowboys. The Dallas Cowboys lost on Sunday Night Football to the Los Angeles Rams in their new $5 billion stadium. They lost 20-17 and had a chance to win the game in the fourth quarter in position, and the Cowboys come up small once again. A team that only scored 3 points, three, in the entire second half. Now, if you look at face value, you just go to the box numbers, to the box score, and look at these stats, they don't look bad. I mean, look at Dak Prescott, 25-39, 266 yards, touchdown, no picks. Now, he did take three sacks, but QBR of only 69, and that kind of tells it all. In the QB rating of 92.5, which doesn't sound bad. But in the second half of this game, the Cowboys, like I said, only scored 3 points, and Dak played horrible. He did not look good at all. And that resulted in the reason why they were able to score 3 points. And in the fourth quarter, donut on the scoreboard. The Cowboys look the same. They look, the offense still looks basic. It still is not explosive. I mean, Dak, 6 yards of completion. 6 yards of completion. That is not explosive. That is not different. That is pretty mundane. Zeke, 22 carries for 96 yards, which is a 4 yard per carry, which is, you know, solid. But once again, not explosive. Still, I mean, he had some electrifying catches and electrifying plays in the game. Like, don't get me wrong, Zeke looked good. But the offense still doesn't pop. For all that it has, for having a top five offensive line, for having a top three receiving core, for having a top three running back, and for having a quarterback that's trying to get $40 million a year, this 17 points ain't going to cut it. 17, it just isn't going to cut it. And then when we look at some of Dak's, the guys that are trying to get paid just like Dak, or that got paid, Patrick Mahomes, Lamar Jackson trying to get paid, and guys that are his contemporaries, this is what I'm going for. They looked amazing. Lamar lit it up. Kyler Murray, young dude, lit it up. Dak Prescott, and then the old guys, some old guys, like the amazing, we saw the guys that are amazing at what they do and they get paid top dollar, Aaron Rodgers, Russell Wilson, Patrick Mahomes. We saw them be great because they are great players. And Dak wants to get paid like a great player, like a great quarterback, and wants to get recognized as a great player, as a great quarterback. And it's just not there. It's not there. 3 points in the second half. Russell Wilson in the first half of his game went 14-15 with 3 touchdowns. He finished the game with 4 touchdowns and 30 completions, 4 incompletions. That's greatness. Aaron Rodgers lit it up for 360 yards and 4 touchdowns. That's greatness. You know? And Dak has more than both of them, maybe more than both of them combined on the offensive side, whether it's a line, running back, receivers, he has it all. And we get a 3-point performance in the second half. We get 17 points in the game. Your defense played great. Alden Smith looked like a revigorated, rejuvenized, energized Alden Smith, the Alden Smith of old. And we hadn't played football in, it seemed like, forever. But Dak Prescott came up small in the clutch, man, and that doesn't get you $40 million a year. That doesn't get you Deshaun Watson's contract. That doesn't get you Patrick Mahomes' money. That don't get you what Lamar Jackson's going to get. 3 points against the Rams, a team who is okay, but maybe the third best team in their division. Maybe. Now, Dallas, fortunately for them, they're in the division with the Eagles and the Washington football team and the Giants. It's a bad division. The Eagles can't block anybody. Washington is Washington. They have a great defensive line, but I don't know how much they can really score. The Eagles just aren't that good, and then the Giants aren't very good either. So they'll probably still win the division, but I'm just saying here, sitting here pointing at these numbers and looking at this game. Now, I don't want to overreact too much, but I'm just saying that's the difference between those guys and Dak. And it's the same. It's a new year, new coach, and y'all told me Mike McCarthy was going to come in and offense was going to revitalize, like, the problem. For years, the problem has been Jason Garrett. For the last decade, the problem has been Jason Garrett. So everybody knew once Jason Garrett moved out, you brought in a Super Bowl winning coach, things would change in Dallas. Well, that offense looks the same. It didn't have anything that was special. It didn't do anything. It wasn't explosive. It was a bunch of dinking and dacking. Dinking and dacking. And I like Dak Prescott, but man, they got to do better. If you want $40 million, you got to better than 6 yards of completion. 10 completions in the second half for in a 50% quarterback rate in the second half. Like, that's not going to do it. Let me know your thoughts on Dak Prescott and Cowboys. Is it a new year the same Cowboys, or will the Cowboys get it together because they do have a new coach and didn't have any offseason? Let me know in the comments down below. Once again, my name is Jeff Lightsy Jr. with the Ball Sports Network. Thank you guys for the continued support. Hit the like, share, subscribe, and notification bell. I'll see you next time.